Friends, in earlier sessions we have discussed various issues as far as our database management system is concerned. I have explained you the way to create database table, the means of database table, the way to create forms and various other controls as far as our database management system is concerned. Today in this part I will discuss how to link two or more database tables. Friends, many times whenever we want to create reports or data entry forms, then it requires more than one tables to be linked to one another. How rather we can create tables, we can link these tables, and the way to use them in various reports or something else, this is discussion which we will have to discuss today. Now, linking database tables. Relationship is the way which is used to link two or more tables. This is, friends, the options available in our MS Access. It is an option which allows to link two or more database tables. Relationship enable to prevent redundant data. That means if one data is available in one table, then it is mandatory to be available in the linked table. Hence, if two or more database tables are linked using relationship, then data entry will be allowed only when there exists a common field among all the tables. One can enforce referential integrity between tables. Now question arises, what is the meaning of referential integrity? So when I want to say something about referential integrity, that means all the table which are linked with one another must have the common data available in the linked field. Referential integrity ensures that information in one table matches information in another table. This information is related to the field which is common among both the linked tables. A relationship works by matching data in key columns using columns with the same name in both the table. That means, friends, when we want to link two or more tables, then there must be a common field among these two tables. In most cases, the relationship matches the primary key from one table, which provides a unique identifier for each row with an entry in the foreign key in the other table. There are various types of linking two or more tables. Mainly, we will be going to highlight three different types. So, there are three types of relationship between tables. One to many relationships. It is the most common type of relationship. In this type of relationship, a row in table A can have many matching rows in table B. That means one row in table A and many rows in table B. But a row in table B can have only one matching row in table A. This is called one to many relationship. Many to many relationship, as the name indicates, in this case both the table will be going to have one or more matching row with reference to one row in another one. In this relationship, a row in table A can have many matching row in table B and vice versa. One to one relationship. In a one to one relationship, a row in table A can have no more than one matching row in table B and vice versa. A one to one relationship is created if both of the related columns are primary keys or have unique constraints. So friends, this was the conceptual aspect of relationship. Now, how to implement it practically in MS Access? So see, in Access 2007, click relationship in the show oblique height group in the database tools tab. As you can see in the ribbon of MS Access, there is one tab having the name database tools. This tab is having one group, show oblique height, and there is an option relationship. So we need to click over database tools, then relationships, and the moment we click over here, hence friends, the moment we click right button of the mouse in relationship pane, then there is a pop-up which appears as shown here. This pop-up contains various options. There is one option which is show table. Now this show tables is used to show various tables which are available in MS Access database. The moment we click this show tables, then here is a list of tables which are available as far as our MS Access database is concerned. As you can see here, there are two different tables. One is item master and another one is sales invoice, that is SAL_INV. Double click the name of the table that we want to relate and then close the show table dialog box. That means here, as you can see, there are two names. Suppose if I want to select item master table, then I need to double click over here. If I want to select sales invoice, then I need to click over here, that is double click. To create a relationship between a table and itself, add that table twice. That means friends, suppose if I want to have a specific relationship which is supposed to be handled among one table with the same table, that means item master table is supposed to be linked with item master table only, then I need to double click this item master table twice. That means first it is linked to relationship, another again it is supposed to be added to the relationship pane. Now that there is a question how to link these two tables. As you can see, there are two tables, sales invoice as well as item master table. Now friends, to link these two tables, as already I have discussed, we require one common field among these two tables. You can notice there is one common field, item number, which is also available in item number as item master table. Here there is one symbol, it indicates that it is the primary key of this item master. That means if I want to add any entry in sales invoice, then there must be corresponding item available in item master. If it is no, then first of all we will have to create it. So drag the field that we want to relate from one table to related field in the another table. That means I will have to click this option, that is item number, and link it to item number in the item master table. Now as you can see, there is one particular symbol 1, and here there is one particular symbol infinite. That means if I want to have a relationship from sales invoice to item master, then this relationship is called many to one. Means many entries of this sales invoice may have linked to one entry of item master table. Now once the relationship is set, we can create reports which automatically picks the required information from respective tables. That means suppose if I want to create a report which is based on sales invoice, then as we know that item master table is linked to sales invoice, automatically the corresponding entries from item master table will be supposed to be displayed in the corresponding report which is supposed to be based on this particular relationship. If we perform data entry in one table, then it automatically checks for the existence of the common value in each linked database table. As already I have conveyed you that suppose if I want to perform data entry in sales invoice table, suppose there is an item number 1001, then the moment I put 1001 in sales invoice table, then first of all it will check whether 1001 is available in item master table or not. If it is available, then and only then it will allow to perform data entry in sales invoice table. That is why we are calling it as relationship, and this is the only case we are calling it as referential integrity. If the data in any table is missing, then before proceeding further, we need to add the required data in the table with primary key field. As already I have shown you that the item master table was having item number as primary key field. Therefore, if I want to add any particular data in sales invoice, then it must be available in item master table. Here there is a particular report which is based on this particular relationship, which was having relation among sales invoice table and item master table. Here is a report created using fields from sales and item master database tables. As you have seen, friends, there was a table sales invoice. It was having various rows which are related to sales invoices. And there is one table item master which contains some master information regarding various items. When I want to create a report, which already we have discussed in our earlier session, the way to create reports. Now, if I want to create report using this relationship, then what you will find, there is one particular field name, item name, which is from item master table, and there is one item number which is common among both the table, and these informations are from sales invoice table. These informations are from sales item master table. So when I want to create report, so it will be going to take care where to call item master, how to link these two files. Only we will going to see whether there is a report from common table. Here I even can add one more thing. When we have created relationship, then the both related table will supposed to be treated as if it were a single table. That is why one particular report is being shown over here. As you can see, friends, there is a report which is based on both the tables. Ideally, we even can create data entry forms which again will be based on both the table, and all kind of referential integrities even can be handled. As you can see, we even have created here reports using two tables. Ideally, using the relationship, we can create series of so many tables as per our requirement. There is no necessity that only two tables need to be linked. We even can create one table to another, another table to another, likewise onwards. There is no limit as such. Now, friends, I'll discuss one another aspect as far as our MS Access is concerned. Here it is menu. What is the meaning of menu? When we will be going to develop an application which is supposed to be thrown to end users who are having least knowledge regarding the corresponding database management system, only they can do one thing. If the options is available on the screen, then by clicking that corresponding option, they will be going to display the corresponding actions, whatever is associated with it. Thus, it will be helpful for them to have user interactions. One can create custom menus in MS Access using many ways. Some of them are, first, using blank form and involving control tools like command button, etc. We can use checkbox, radio buttons, etc. Using macros, even using modules, using pop-up menus. Here we will discuss simple menu creation using blank form and involvement of control tools like command button, etc. Now, friends, to create menu, first of all, as I have shown you that I am going to explain the concept of menu using blank form. So first of all, as you can see, I'll have to create blank form. To create menu, one need to select create tab from the ribbon and blank form from the form group. So as you can see, in MS Access database, there is one particular option, that is create tab in the ribbon. This create tab contains one option, that is form. So this form group contains one option form, and the moment if we create form, then there is one option blank form. So this blank form need to be selected over here as far as our menu creation is concerned. If I need to click over this blank form, then some sort of such blank form appears over the screen. So the blank form appears as follows, which is shown over here. Now, as per our requirement, we even can add any of the control tools which are available over the control options. Now friends, the moment we click right button of the mouse over blank form, then one pop-up appears as follows. There is an option design view. Design views is an option which will be going to allow us to create the form as per our own requirement, as we simply need to create menu. So therefore, whatever buttons are required, we can use them as per requirement. So using the design view, by clicking the right button of the mouse on blank form, we see one pop-up as follows. Now I'll have to create click over design view. The design view appears as follows. The design tab contains various control which are used to create menu. As you can see friends, this particular design tab is the new one which was not available in our earlier concept. Now friends, as you can see, there is one group which is control. This group contains various control options. As you can see, it is the button, it is the label, it is the text box. These are various other options. This is radio button, this is checkbox. So likely any of the controls we even can add to our blank form as per our requirement. Here I need to assign label to this particular menu. So naturally, being the first menu, I am going to add the label as main menu to this particular form. Now when label is selected, I simply need to drag this label to this design view and assign a particular caption, that is main menu, to this particular option. When caption is being assigned, then definitely it will ask you to add various font, various style, etc. So here this is the size which I have selected, which is sufficient enough as far as our proper display of the menu is concerned. Now after assigning the caption, that is main menu, to this particular design view, now naturally as far as actions are concerned, I'll have to use any of the tools like button, radio button, checkbox, etc. So here I am going to explain you the way how to display reports if it is being clicked using a command button. So here there is a button, and now in the next option I'll add the command button to design view. For adding it, simply I need to drag this to this location. By default it will show you command 1 or command 2 or command 3, depending upon the way how many commands already we have added to this particular design view. The moment this button is being left over this design view, it will again ask for a particular pop-up menu, and this pop-up menu asks for two different options. One is category and another one is action. This category contains various navigation options regarding record operations, form operations, report operations, etc. So friends, naturally as I have explained you that my motto here is to display report when this command button is being clicked. So here I have selected report operations as far as the category is concerned, and in the actions, the second option, that is open report, that I have selected. Now after selecting these two options, I need to click the next button over this particular pop-up menu. Here is the next view. Now it will ask for the corresponding report which you need to display. So in the next option of wizard for command button, ask for the name of the report to be displayed when click event will be triggered. That means when I will be going to trigger the click event over this particular button, then what kind of report should be displayed. So therefore it asks for the corresponding report. Presently it is showing only one report, it is item master. Otherwise we even can display various reports as per our requirement. So whatever report already we have created in the database management system, all kind of reports will be displayed over here, as it is showing only one particular report name. That is why, simply because of that, already I have created one report in this MS Access database management. Next option allows to provide name of the command button. Here we have provided item master report, as you can see, friend, over here. So the moment I write type item master report in this particular box, so this particular button will be going to display the item master report, and after providing it, I need to create finish. When finish button is being clicked, so there are two options, as already I have created. One is main menu and another one is item master. So now we have created a main menu which is having one label and one command button. The now the command button item master is being clicked, then corresponding report will be going to display. So for displaying main menu, first of all I'll have to run this particular menu from this option. So when we run the form, then it appears as follows. Two options are there. There is no design view. It is simply the way when execution has been started. And now the moment I click over item master, then what is going to happen? The corresponding report, that is item master report, will be going to be displayed. So as you can see, this is the report which is supposed to be the result of that particular command button. So if I want to say in with respect to end user, then simply end user need to run the corresponding application, and if the corresponding command button like item master or whatever we have created will be displayed, then corresponding report will be displayed. So there is no any necessity of knowing, have the knowledge of MS Access or something else. Simply application need to be executed over the corresponding site of the end user. Friends, today I have discussed the way to link two or more tables. We simply need to take care of having one common field among the tables being linked. We even can have many tables which even can be linked. Only one common field should be there between the linked tables. We even have seen the way to create reports, forms based on relationship. Referential integrity will be a part as far as our relationship is concerned. We, friends, have seen the way to create main menu. This main menu will very helpful as far as end user user interaction is concerned. Simply end user need to click over the corresponding button and corresponding action will be displayed to him.